Good morning, dear participants and the resource person of the overseas webinar, Dr. Nasreen Sultan. Myself, Pashwanath Ajri from Department of Commerce, take great pleasure in welcoming all of you to our last program of this COVID time webinar series, that is advertising the future casualties. All of us fully aware that the advertising is indispensable for any business. Every business spends a huge amount of money on this head, the burden of which, of course, is ultimately passed on to the ultimate consumer. But then, unfortunately, the present day advertisements are totally misleading and they make tall claims and they give false statements and also lack ethical sanction. Against this background, in this webinar, the resource person of today's webinar is going to present before you the far-reaching impacts and the casualties of the present-day advertisement upon the future generation. Now, I request our principal, Dr. Sudarshan Kumar, to welcome everybody formally to this webinar.
Good morning, everybody. The Department of Commerce of our college has organized an international webinar on the topic advertising the future casualties. This international webinar will be inaugurated by our dynamic secretary, Sri Abhijit M. of Digambara Jaina Vidyavardhaka Sangha, Moodibidri. Hearty welcome to you, sir. The resource person of today's webinar is Dr. M. Nasreen Sultana, Assistant Professor, Faculty of Business and Management Studies, Gulf College, Sultanate of Oman. Because of our former colleague, Srimati Pavitra Shetty, we are very much lucky to have Dr. M. Nasreen Sultana as a resource person. On behalf of the college and the organizing committee, a warm welcome to you, madam. The college feels proud to welcome our former colleague, Srimati Pavitra Shetty. On this occasion, I am happy to welcome the organizing committee members, Dr. Padmaja Shetty, coordinator of IQAC, Mr. Mahavir Ajri, convener of the program, Mr. Parshwanath Ajri, program coordinator, Srimati Akshita Marathe, technical coordinator, and all my teacher friends. Last but not least, I cordially welcome the participants, that is the national as well as the international, who make the program a successful one. Thank you.
Now I request the management secretary of our college, Sri M. Abhijit, to inaugurate this webinar. Over to you, sir.
Welcome to all of you. During this pandemic period, this is where the information is flown across the globe without any filters. So everybody is informed. So yes, a competition or a challenge for an advertising people who are in the advertising field. The information in this globe is free flowing. Filter it in a very special, unique way to present it to the world the way it has to be. I am really proud that you have chosen this subject. I welcome all the participants. I'm also proud to inaugurate this webinar. It's really great that I could do it from my canteen rather than going to a hall and inaugurating it. I'm really happy and I wish all of you a very successful seminar and hope all of you will enjoy it. Thank you.
I now request Sri Professor Mahavir Ajri to introduce the guest of this webinar.
Good morning to all. It's my pleasure to introduce today's resource person, Dr. M. Nasreen Sultana, Assistant Professor, Gulf College, Oman. Dr. M. Nasreen Sultana, graduate with the BCom and postgraduate with the MBA from Fatima College, Madurai. She has completed her MPhil from MK University, PGDCA and PhD in Management Science from Jawaharlal Nehru Technical University, Hyderabad. She has published more than 30 research papers in various reputed referred journals with high impact factor and participated as resource person in various national and international seminars and conferences. Having more than 16 years of teaching experience in Gulf College, Oman, she has bestowed Academic Excellence Award in teaching consecutively for 3 years, and she was also awarded Outstanding Teacher Award in Gulf College, Oman. She has got Young Scientist Award for Business Management Research, and her paper was awarded Best Marketing Research Paper in Michigan University. Currently, one of her research proposal in the topic 4 P's into 4 E's, that is how to avoid the unbalancing marketing mix and its impact on tourism in Oman, was approved by the Research Council of Oman. Moreover, this research proposal was fully funded by the Research Council of Oman. With this brief introduction, I have a great pleasure welcome to this seminar our resource person, Dr. M. Nasreen Sultana. I request to take over the session. Over to you, madam. Thank you.
Good morning to one and all. Hope you are fine, staying safe and healthy. I'm very glad to provide you a talk on advertising the future casualties. I thank Principal Sir, Secretary Sir, and every one of you people in Sri Davla College. I welcome all the participants. As your secretary has told, you will really enjoy my session. It will not be very monotonous, like putting some points and just to talk. I'll show you some of the advertisement also. I know that like whenever we are watching any television program, a serial, reality show or a movie, when we get advertisement, what we normally will do? We will skip the ad or we will change the channel, right? We don't like the advertisements. But in reality, many of the companies or any business professional who want to increase his business or who want to increase his sale, he invests plenty of amount in advertisement. Not only business, even like say for example, beginning of this session, they introduced me, that is also a self-marketing or self-advertisement. So advertisement is our part of life. Everywhere, every day, every life, whenever you travel outside also, you see advertisements, so many things. But lot of changes are there in advertisements. So many types of advertisements are there. So like another few more minutes, we are going to discuss what is it, what is exactly the advertisement, what are its types are there, like what exactly the business people are doing, that is what we are going to see. And at the end of the session, we will also see some of the advertisements which are focused on like how our future will be. So I'll just share my screen. I hope you are able to see my screen. If so, can you please tell me so that I can continue? You are able to see my screen?
Yeah, madam, you can continue.
Okay, thank you, sir. So today's topic was about advertising the future casualties. I am Dr. Nasreen from Gulf College, Oman. So first we are going to discuss what is advertisement. Before I would like to continue my presentation, I would like to tell the participant that please have a paper and pen with you. Make note of some of the information, because at the end we will have a game with few questions like a quiz game. So it will be helpful for you when you listen my presentation, take a note, what you are seeing, what you are watching, what I am telling, that will add more points at the end for you in the quiz. So I request you to take a paper and pen with you. In the chat box, you can click ready, then I will start my presentation. Okay, I think hope you are ready with your paper and pen. So first we will start with like, what is advertisement? From where we got this word advertisement? It's a Latin derived word. So advertisement in Latin, ad means towards. I repeat again, ad means towards, verto means in turn. So literally it means to turn the attention of the public towards a specific thing. So they want to grab the attention of the people. Yes, of course, it is true that with the help of advertisement, we want to seek attention of each and every individual who are there. Because once the information has been reached to the public, then only our product will become more popularity, our brand will become more popularity, and the sales will increase, in turn our profit will increase. So advertisement means to turn the attention of the people towards specific things. It may be a product or services. Now we will see a definition. So advertisement is only form of paid non-personal presentation of ideas, goods or services for the purpose of including people to buy. So here this definition was given by Wheeler. So what he is telling is that advertisement is any form of paid. It is paid. It is not free of cost. So if suppose any business wants to create an advertisement, they need to pay for creating that particular advertisement. So what will be there in advertisement? It is having personal presentation of ideas about goods and services. So about any product or about any services. Say for example, if they are going to start an hospital, then also they need an advertisement about the services, what are the facilities they are having. Even academic institution also need advertisement. So they will tell what all the courses are there in the college or what all the facilities are there in the college. Like that, an ad will be created. So this is for the people to utilize the service or to buy the product. Okay. Now we will see one old advertisement. Volume will be a little feeble, just manage, okay? And I hope many of them have seen this advertisement. Okay, from this advertisement, what all the things we can grab or what all the things we can observe. Now, say for example, this is, as I told you, very, very old advertisement. And this is an advertisement of TV channel DD National. And they have used the slogan as Satyam Sivam Sundaram. And in this advertisement, you can see the clarity is not there. The only one music they have used, no dialogues, no human. We don't have any other things like it. Maybe to create this advertisement at that time, it will be very costly. But right now, in fraction of second, we can create this advertisement. Nowadays, lot of TV channels, they have different advertisement, and very frequently, according to the occasion, according to the season, they will change the advertisement. They change the logos to create an impact in the minds of the public. So this is an old advertisement. Now we will see what is a recent one, like in future, how the advertisement will be. Advertisement and its impact on future, we are going to see how the advertisement is there in future. This is a coffee cup. In one touch, we can know the heartbeat. We can scan our health. This is touchscreen calendar. This is a food cutter which can tell you the calories of the food also. All the details about the product you can see. So that is one thing. In car window, we can increase the AC, control the AC, everything. In school, we can play with the computerized boy. This is a digital writer. School kids are using tab. Educom classes used. This is a notebook, a digital notebook. On one touch, we can call a person to with whom we want to talk. So with digital watch, we can zoom it over like a projector and we can talk to them as face to face. So this is like a calculator, but a password protector. In business also, we are using technology. Okay, this is a very interesting advertisement which you have seen right now, where a lot of technological advanced equipments and products have been used here. So from the beginning, you can see the man who is using the coffee cup. In one touch, he could know what is his heartbeat, how was his health, and it is showing excellent. Then if you could see that in this advertisement, everything is created in naturally in what is happening in our normal life, like getting up early from the bed, the kid is getting up from the early from the bed, and there is a digital calendar next to his bed. On one touch, the calendar is showing the date, what is the date of the day, and what is the weather condition. It is also shown there. Again, you can see the lady in kitchen, she is using a digital vegetable cutter. So what is the benefit of digital vegetable cutter is, like, what product you are cutting, it will show the exact calories of that particular product and full information. What is the nutritive value about it, everything. So you might have seen she is cutting a bell pepper in that particular cutter and how much calories it is there. Then the kid is going to school and everything is digitalized in the school. Nothing, the old chalk and talk method, nothing is there. So the teacher is also using Educom class. So what is Educom class? The exact thing we can zoom and we can show to the audience, and we can teach in depth everything. Suppose, say for example, we want to study about the heart. What is a human heart? Now in the digital Educom class, the teacher can show the human heart. She can zoom the heart. She can show this is the right ventricle, this is left ventricle, this is aorticle, this is vein, this is arteries, the blood is flowing, pure blood is going in arteries, impure blood is taken in vein. Everything she can zoom and show to the students, so that the education is very faster and it is very interesting for the students to learn. So this is one such advertisement which was created by Samsung Display. So they are displaying what all the products they are having in their market. All the product information is also given. Now you might have noticed a difference, like old advertisement versus the future advertisements. Everything is like wow factor is also involved in it. Okay, now we will see some of the impact of advertisement, like what all the informations, or why we need to see advertisement, or what we need to get from advertisement, or why we have to create advertisement. That is what we are going to see now. So first thing is, we are going to discuss about differentiate the product from the competitor. So how I am going to differentiate from my product with my competitor product? This is very, very important point. So to differentiate my product, definitely I have to create advertisement. Now here I have put an first image of a garlic fruitix shampoo advertisement. So in this you can see I am going to differentiate my product. Now what I am telling from my product, like from Garnier Fruitix, this shampoo is made with green apple extract, so which will strengthen my hair, or it will give softness to my hair. So the green apple color is green, so I am also making my packaging in green. So in this way I am differentiating my product with that of another product. You might have seen so many advertisement, like say for example Clinique Plus shampoo advertisement. They show that they are using milk protein in that shampoo, so the shampoo color is also pure white. And when the ad was created also, they are telling that the hair will grow silky, strong and healthy. In the ad also, the mother will talk to the daughter telling that you should be stronger from your inside. So they mean to say that when we use Clinique Plus shampoo, the hair will get stronger from the inside. So they communicate that. So now you can see in Garnier Fruitix a different advertisement. Even Garnier Almond shampoo and all, they have used that lady tying her hair in a car, and she is pulling the car, and she tells that her hair has become stronger by using that almond shampoo. The almond makes the hair very strong, like that. So this is how each and every competitor show difference in their advertisement, and they attract the eyes of the customers. So this is how we differentiate the product from the competitors one. Now second point is to communicate product information. Now whenever an advertisement is created, a product information should be reached to the customer. Now here you can see in this image, Pond's Age Miracle product, in this image they have used younger looking skin in 7 days. This is the product information what they have projected. So they want to create in the minds of the customer that if they use Pond's Age Miracle, they can look more younger than the age, what is their age. So this is an miracle in the age. Within 7 days, your skin will have a good tone, and you look more beautiful, and very healthy skin will be there. So that is what they are telling, that if you want to look younger, you have to use Pond's Age Miracle. That is what the advertisement is telling. Like already inauguring person have told that, like, some of the advertisements are misleading facts are there. We are not going for about that, whether the advertisement is telling the truth or it is following ethics or it is misleading. I'm not going in depth on these discussion. It is true that some of the products are providing misleading information. Only their intention is to increase their sale and increase their profit. But certain products definitely, yes, like Pond's Age Miracle and all, they are using some serum, and which is really very healthy and very good. Even when ladies used to go to the parlor, in what products they are using to make the skin glow, those products have been used in Pond's Age Miracle also. So this is some trustworthy advertisement there also there, that will, that also we will see in some examples. Now, third point is to urge product use. Now, how we have to make the people create a curiosity to buy the product and use. Now, you can see the Fair and Lovely advertisement. Maybe this advertisement, I can say a misleading advertisement also. It will never, never, ever change your complexion. It can give you some brightness for a temporary basis, but it is not a permanent basis. What is your color of your skin or color of your skin tone? It is going to remain same. But in Fair and Lovely advertisement, you can see that, like starting from my left hand side, the skin tone is very dark, and from right hand side, the face, you can see it is very bright, fair, and she's smiling. She's having a big smile on her face. So in advertisement, when you see the real advertisement of Fair and Lovely, they have used like, now recent advertisement was they are using HD glow, high definition glow. When you use Fair and Lovely cream, face cream, you will have a glow in your face. That is what they are creating an urge among the people to buy. So those who are in dark complexion, especially like me, definitely at least one time we will buy the Fair and Lovely product and we will use. So it will urge us, like we think, okay, like fair complexion means it is more warm, well-hung to be recognized in the community, like that we used to think. But believe me, of course, it is not going to do anything, not going to provide you any magic on you. But it creates an urge. So because of advertisement, some of the advertisement create urge to use that particular product. At least one time in your lifetime, you will buy the product and you will use the product. So this is also one impact on people. Then the fourth point I want to talk to you about was to expand the product distribution. Now, this is one important factor for business perspective. The business people, they want to distribute their product in the entire market. Now, say for example, if I ask you a question, can you tell me a name of a soft drink? Then immediately everyone will tell Coke or Pepsi. But in fact, in local market, like lot of products are manufactured, especially in Madurai, you have a soft drink called Kali Mark Bovento. But why immediately, whenever anybody asks a question, tell me a soft drink, means immediately Coke or Pepsi has captured the minds of the public. Because whichever country, wherever you travel, anywhere you will find this product availability. So this shows that how Coke and Pepsi have distributed their product worldwide. So expanding the product distribution worldwide will also create more popularity, and it creates a good brand image or product image in the minds of the public. Okay, so this is one thing. So here this advertisement was about an insurance advertisement, insurance company which is used in Oman. So they have created this advertisement. This is a consultancy firm where they provide distribution in various channels. They used to distribute. We all know what is distribution channel also, like from the manufacturer, it goes to the wholesaler. From wholesaler, it goes to the retailer. Then from retailer, it goes to the customer. So this is the distribution channel of distribution, we say. But in fact, now the distribution channel is reduced directly from the manufacturer to the customer through online marketing. Like we have teleshopping network, direct online marketing, Amazon.com, we have so many online websites we are having. they are telecasting the advertisement also, so in online. So when you use those advertisement, we can buy the product directly from the online. So distribution channel is also going on reducing nowadays, but still the business professionals need to invest some amount for product distribution. Okay, now next point, point number 5, to provide brand preference and loyalty. Yes, it is very, very important. We have a theory called leaky bucket theory. You know bucket, right? A bucket is like a shape like this, where it has the mouth, very wider mouth, and the bottom is fully closed. The entry is, we want the customer to enter more and more. Like more customers should enter inside the business, but I don't want to lose my customers. So I close my edge, bottom of the bucket. So there is no exit. That means whatever the customer I am getting, I want to retain the customer. Say for example, you take a jewelry shop. What this jewelry shop people are doing? Once a customer goes, they just have an intention to just see what is the price of the gold, or how the product are there, what are the design, just to get an idea. But once you enter the shop, they will brainwash you in such a way, and they will give you more offers, they will attract you, they will retain you, and they will make you to buy at least a small piece of product of a gold, a small at least a nose stud or a ring or whatever it is. They will brainwash you in such a way that you buy the product and go out of that particular shop. Now, another thing what they do is that they will record the customer information in their system. We say CIS, customer information system. So when they use this customer information system, they will ask your birth date or anniversary date. And before a day ahead of your birthday, they will call you. They will tell you that because of your birthday, some 50 rupees discount is there, 100 rupee discount is there, or there are no making charges there for you. Like this, they maintain a relationship with the customer. So when they maintain the relationship with the customer, we will have the loyalty towards the brand. Now I have showed you the Colgate advertisement. You have seen the various series of Colgate advertisement. Old advertisement of Colgate, old man breaking the shell of walnut, and he shows that Colgate is for strong teeth. But now you can see we are using celebrities like Jyothika and all in the advertisement for Colgate Ved Shakti ad and all, you might have seen. And one advertisement have been created where the mother, some mothers, like not only one mother, 4 or 5 mothers, they will be talking to the general public through the advertisement, telling that when Colgate is used by her mom for her, and she is passing on the same loyalty to her daughter because she trusts that Colgate creates a strong teeth, as well as teeth will be protected from decaying. Okay, so this is what called as an advertisement which have been created to provide brand preference and loyalty. So this is one such advertisement. Then now I am going to talk about the last point, to reduce overall sales. Now say for example, Coca-Cola is one best product which wants to reduce the cost and increase the sale. So this is their intention, not Mega-Cola, it is Mecca-Cola. So here they are producing a very big pack, of giant pack, not than a normal family pack, at a lesser cost. They increase the sale. So when they reduce the cost, automatically the product moves in the market very fast. It attracts the market, and through their advertisement, they attract the people and they make the people to buy the products. Okay. Now we will just talk about what are the different types of advertisement. There are so many different types of advertisement. First one is, we are having print advertisement. So like a poster or a pamphlet or a brochure, we print the advertisement and we circulate it. Second is outdoor advertisement, going outside the business place and we do advertisement. Say for example, going to a mall, having a hoardings or having a screen of our product and display, and we do advertisement, it is called as outdoor advertisement. Then we are having we are having celebrity advertisement, so where we are using some celebrities in the advertisement. Then public servicing advertisement. So what is public servicing advertisement? So here the advertisement is created to provide services, like say for example, due to COVID-19, how to protect ourselves. Some ad has been telecasted from WHO, World Health Organization, and it is called as public service advertising. Surrogate advertising. So what is surrogate advertising means? It is an advertising which is created for harmful products. Say for example, for cigarettes, for alcohol and all, they cannot create an advertisement directly right now because of there is an advertising board to control the ad ethics also. So what they do, like say for example, Bagpiper Club Soda. So they created a soda ad with the alcohol branded name of the product. Like that, they are doing an advertisement, means that is called as surrogate advertising. Then we have covert advertising. So what is covert advertising is commercializing the advertisement. Like say for example, in a cinema theater and all, they create an advertisement and they say in the break you go and have a mini snack in the counter. That is also a covert advertisement. Then the last one is broadcasting advertisement. I request everyone to mute the mic, please. So broadcast advertisement is also broadcasting the advertisement in online, through online channels, online mode. We will see some of the advertisements here in my advertisement. Okay. Now I will show you, these are the types of advertisement. Now I will share with you some of the advertisements which have been used recently now in online. They are using digital technology. Now all the advertisements are maximum created using digital advertising technique with latest technology. We will see this ad now. Please observe the ad very closely. Some of the questions will come from this also. We are living in future. This is holographic ads for Apple iPhone. Hypervision technology is used with direct link of satellite. LED spine on brackets, it is used to create an illusion of the advertisement. Not only one product, many products we can show. So this is created by Kinomo company. It's already used by brand like Samsung and Intel. So this is an advertisement created by Tech Insight. So a lot of technology has been used here. Say for example, they are using satellite link directly linked with LED display through a brackets, and a holographic ad is created with the help of hyperlink vision. Okay, so this is first used by Samsung and Intel, and they are using the digital advertisement. Now in this advertisement you might have seen a jewelry shop people are using to display their rings or jewelries. A burger company is using, Apple iPhone is also using the advertisement. Shoes companies can also use this advertisement. Like that, they have created the advertisement. The next part we are going to see about corporate social responsibility. Like we talk about ethics. So definitely there should be some ethical values to be followed. Companies should not think, the business should not think only about profit. They should think about the society also. So CSR means corporate social responsibility. Each company, they do take care of the society also, because if society is well and good, the product will be sold in the market, and when the product is sold in the market, they can get more profit. We can see this is one such corporate ad created. Please observe the ad very carefully. This is an advertisement of Coca-Cola. In Philippines, there is a place called Pasco. This is a hypermarket. So people are visiting the hypermarket. It is a mall. In the mall, there is a gift wrapping section. This is a girl who is wrapping the gift from the morning till night. It is the day of Christmas. So she is wrapping more and more gifts. She is feeling that she was not able to spend time with their parents and brothers and sister. And she is very sad also. He is a person in the counter to pack the stuff of the people, help them. His father is very sick, so he has to leave his studies and he is working. And on Christmas Day, he is missing his father also. In the same mall, there is a food court where in the food court, he is a serving person. And imagine on Christmas Day, it is very difficult to serve food. Very hard because the entire day he has to be busy. And he was missing his family so much. So for Christmas, they have created a mini Coke like this. The last customer of that particular day, in the midnight, a customer is packing lot of foodstuff, product or household items. She is telling sorry because I have purchased a lot. And another person is giving lot of gifts to the gift wrapping lady and telling that I'm so sorry, please wrap all the gift. And the lady is going late night and asking to ordering meals, like lot of food she is ordering. Now you see this lady is sharing the small bottle of Coke and she said that all the groceries, whatever she has packed, it is for that guy only. Again, all the gifts, whatever it is packed, that is for that lady. See her emotions. Not only for only these three people, 15,000 people, more than 15,000 people, they got gift hampers from Coca-Cola company to make the Christmas Day celebration and auspicious day celebration. So this is a thing which a person have to keep in their mind when they are doing a business that they should also do take care of the society. Now, I'll just show you an ad which is created by, like how the advertisements are created, with whom we are creating the advertisement. So just we will see, we will watch what is it. It's very interesting one. Okay, so what we have seen in this advertisement is that how the ad agencies create the advertisements. So they use a team of people like ad director or ethical dealing considerations. Everything is dealt by an lady or a marketing person. Like that, we have so many like web developer to develop the advertisement. So we have all these people to create an advertisement. So in this thing, we are seeing that they are creating only one product. That is a collar neck belt for a cat. So you can see like how it is manufactured, like how it is branded, given a brand name, how it is given a logo or whatever it is, a packaging. Then finally, how the sales, and at last, the ad agency tells that because of their advertisement, how the market has been increasing its sale also. Everything is done in that particular advertisement. So I know everyone likes cartoons. So this advertisement has been created with the help of a cartoon. The last one, before I could conclude, how our future will be in another 20 years till 2090, we are going to see in this advertisement future casualties. So you can see very close to this advertisement. So again, some questions may be from this advertisement. So each year, what advanced technology is going to come, that is what we are going to see in this advertisement. So 2090, vehicles are flying in the air. You can see car is flying, scooters is flying. 2070, we are going to have a spaceship bus with more people. So on the rails of the road, we will have spaceship instead of bus. 2050, we will have markets. For everyone, we will have bonus points, digital points when we do marketing. This is 2030, we will have digital advertisement on bus. You can see Coca-Cola ad on the bus. The bus is also a triple tucker bus. See, three partitions are there. In the door, you know, you should choose where you have to go. You have to choose in the door itself. So you might have observed that in 2090, in the air, all the vehicles will fly. Nothing will go in the road. Okay, like with the help of remote technology, remote sensor technology, robotics technology and all, the car or whatever vehicle we are using in the roads now, everything will fly in the air in 2090. Hope we will not be there to see that. 2070, you can see that there will be a space ship bus. You might have seen the spaceship flying in the air, but it will be on the roads using a rail, and the capacity will be like more people will be accommodated in that. Okay, then 2050, you can see in the market also, when we use a trolley, just touching the trolley, whatever product you put in the trolley, it will add bonus points. It will save your cost. You can buy more product. And for each person, whatever product they are using, everything will be marketed with some market value point. In 2030, that is in another 10 more years, you can see digital advertisements on the bus. It is shown. It's a triple tucker bus where Coca-Cola Zero ad is like zero calories ad is also put on the bus. So wherever a person wants to go, they have to click that the place, like 21st Street means you have to click the street, then automatically you get inside. You will have a digital pass for that to travel in those buses. So these are the future casualties what are going to happen in near future. I hope you have enjoyed my presentation. If you have any queries, you can ask me. Over to you. I have done with from my side. You have any questions, you can ask me now.
No question. Madam, we have not received any questions so far.
Okay, sir.
Please proceed with your questions, madam.
Okay, I have a small quiz here.
Yeah, whatever you would like to do, you can proceed with that.
Yeah. I want everyone to minimize the presentation screen and open Kahoot.it. www.kahoot.it. Please open that.
Madam, please give the link in the chat box.
One second, sir. Like in Google, they should type Kahoot, Kahoot. Let me see the chat.
Meanwhile, madam, please, we have got one question.
Yes, sir.
Shall I read out?
Yes, yes.
Yes, yes. Which is the most shocking advertisement you have seen?
Shocking.
Which is the most shocking advertisement you have seen?
Even this display-centric ad given by Samsung, that is most shocking for me, because in a coffee cup, when we touch and we will see our full health condition in one touch of holding the cup, it's a shocking thing. It's an advancement of technology I will never ever imagine. And what coffee cup I am using, it's of made of a ceramic cup only. So it's the most amazing advertisement what I have seen so far in my lifetime.
Okay, madam. Okay, thank you. Please proceed with the questions, madam.
I will just put it in the...
Put the link in the chat box.
Chat box. I'm not able to go to chat box. Okay, I have seen chat box. Chat box is not opening, sir. Can you type on behalf of me, Kahoot? You can see in my screen. You are able to see my screen? Are you able to see my screen?
Oh, got it, madam. Got it. We got it.
Okay, Kahoot, I will start the game. Before that, I would like to tell you the instruction, okay?
Okay.
A question will be displayed with the four options. And for the audience, four colors will come, like orange, blue, green, whatever color, four colors will come. So for each question, some 30 seconds time is there, only 30 seconds. Whatever answers they want to click, they have to click immediately. So who is going to click with the very minimum seconds, they will be considered as the winner of the game. Okay.
Okay.
So this is a tech thing which I am using with Kahoot. You can use this. So I'll start the game now.
Okay, madam.
Okay, game pin. Can you share the game pin?
Yeah, I will give you the game pin. One second. I'll just connect the account now. So you guys are ready to join? Game pin is 763001. It is display in the screen. 763001.
Yeah, yeah.
Using your nickname, you can join. Please join. So far, nobody have joined. 763001. One player have joined. Everyone, whoever is seeing this webinar, all can participate. The faculty, students, outsiders, whoever is there. 763001. is a game pin. Very good. I need more participants. 763001 is game pin. You can put your nickname, short name. Don't worry, your answer is right or wrong. Nothing is going to tell. 14 players, 15 players have joined. Game pin is 763001. Yeah. 30 players. Wow, I want more of them to join. 763001 is a game pin. I have seen 90 participants are there. So still more can join. Then I will start the quiz. Okay, I think we will start the game. We will not waste the time much.
Please proceed, madam. Can please.
Okay, start. It's a webinar from my side. It's a quiz, 10 question. First question, in the word advertisement ad refers to forward, towards, backward, none of the above. Click one answer. First answer is forward. Second, blue color is towards. Yellow color is backward. Green is none of the above. Okay, answer is towards. So 12 of them have given correct answer. We will go to the next question. You have to be very fast. So you can see here in the scoreboard, Red Snail has got 938 points out of 1000. Next question. We are going for next question. So be fast. Aquatic stroke. You're just behind with few scores. Be quick in answer. Four colors will be there. Choose the color, the right one, faster, okay? Next question on the board. In the word advertisement, verto means back turn is red, front turn is blue, in turn is yellow, turn in is green. Back turn, front turn, in turn, turn in. Okay, all the 35 have answered, 36 people. Good job. 15 of them have given correct answer. Verto means in turn. So you might have seen that all the questions are there from my presentation only. So again, now scoreboard, very good. Wow, aquatic stroke, you have overcome the person. Now in second position, Greet Meerkat is there. So I want to be faster. aquatic stroke, you have to retain your position. We'll go for the next question. Third question, true or false? Advertisement means to turn the attention of people towards specific thing. Is it true or false? True means blue, false means red. Be fast to answer. Wow, amazing. It is true. 37 have given true as the answer. Very good. Great job. We will see who is on the top in the leading board. Very good. Aquatic stroke is on leading again. Amazing Gazella, few more points, like 400 plus. You can catch over in other questions. We'll see the next question. Old advertisement shown was about what? I show a old advertisement is about NDTV red, ZTV blue, Vijay TV yellow, DD National green. So about which TV it was? Okay, all 40 have answered. Okay, 42. Very good. 35 have given correct answer. It was about Doordarshan, National TV. We will go for the scoreboard. Very good. Aquatic stroke, you are in leading. Amazon, you have to take over. Only 300 points. Next question, you can pick it up. Fifth question, advertisement showing about the impact of future created by Nokia, Samsung or Idea, which company? Nokia is in red, Idea is in blue, Samsung in yellow. Okay, all 42 have answered. Okay. So it was about Samsung. Again, 20 people have. I didn't talk anything about Idea company. Okay, Samsung was correct answer. Next question, be ready. We will see who is on top in the scoreboard. Wow, amazing. Aquatic stroke in 4,705 points. Amazon with 4,342 points. Red snail, 3,710 points. You'll see who. What is the next question now? Sixth question. First image advertisement was about. I show you a picture advertisement. It was about which one? A clue was product differentiation. So red is Fructic shampoo, Dove shampoo, yellow Colgate, Fair and Lovely is in green. Image. Product differentiation with competitors. Okay, 14 of them have given right answer. It was a Garnier Fructic shampoo advertisement. We'll go for the next. We'll see the scoreboard. Very good. Aquatic stroke is in leading now. We'll go for the next question. Seventh question. Advertisement. This display about product information. It shows product information. Red is Fair & Lovely, blue Pond's Age Miracle, C Colgate, D Doordarshan. Three more answers. Good, it is about Pond's Age Miracle and the product information shown was Enger in 7 days. That is the product information. You will see the scoreboard now. Wow, aquatic stroke. Yeah, he has scored 6,531 points. Amazing, you have to click the answer very fast because even a single second will increase your points. We'll go to next question. Eighth question. LED brackets were connected with satellites. This was used in digital advertisement. First used by which company? Nokia and Intel, Samsung and Intel, Japan, China. Nokia in red, Samsung and Intel in blue, Japan in yellow, China in green. It's first used by which company or implemented by which company? Okay, I have got 41 answers. 42 answered. One more is there who has not answered. Okay, we got the answer. Very good. It is about Samsung and Intel. 25 of you have got given the correct answer. We will go for the next scoreboard, then question. Amazing. Aquatic Stroke is on lead. Second position was by Amazon Gazella and third by Bright Oryx. Red Snail in fourth position again. We will see the next question. Two more questions only. So pick up your score. Still someone can beat Aquatic Stroke. Ninth question. Ad showing future casualties in the year, it is 2090. In 2090, what will happen? It's wrongly written as 2020. 2090, what will happen? Red, vehicle fly in the air. Blue, spaceship. Three, digital advertisement, market valued with points. 2019, what will happen? Yes, correct. Vehicles fly in the air. Again, same advertisement, future casualties. In another year, what is going to happen? You can see again, Aquatic Stroke is in lead. Last question. In the year 2070, what will happen? In future casualties ad. Spaceship will carry more passenger or digital advertisement on bus, vehicle will fly in the air, or marketing done with point system. This is the last question. Yes, spaceship will carry more passenger. This is the answer, correct answer. So you will see the final scoreboard. Wow. Third position, Smiling Hair. Second position, Amazon Gazella. And first position, any guessings? Aquatic Stroke. Congratulations for the winners. Fourth position was Bright Oryx. So thank you for participating actively in the game also. So over to the organizer. Sir?
Okay, madam. We have come to the end of this webinar. We don't have any more questions in the chat box.
Okay,
come to the end of this webinar. I take this opportunity to thank profusely the resource person of this webinar, Dr. Nasreen Sultana, for all the pain you have taken in making this webinar a successful one. Thank you very much, madam.
Thank you so much, sir.
I also thank all the participants who have registered and participated in this webinar. A big thank to all the participants. I also thank Srimati Pavitra Shetty, our former colleague, who has helped us in contacting the resource person of this webinar. Thank you, Pavitra Shetty, madam. Once again, we are grateful to you. Our thanks are also due to inaugurator of this webinar, Shriyam Abhijit, the secretary of our management committee. Thank you, sir. I also thank our principal, Dr. Sudarshan Kumar, who presided over this webinar. Thank you, sir. I also thank the organizing committee members, Shri Mahavirajri, the convener, Santosh Shetty, and the technical coordinator, Srimati Akshata Marate and Kumari, for assisting us in completing this webinar in a good manner. Thank you, madams. I also thank all the persons who have directly and indirectly helped us in conducting this webinar. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you, sir. I can leave the session, right?
Thank you, madam, once again. Thank you.
Okay, sir.
To the attention of the participants, the feedback link has been given in the chat box. Please use that for giving the feedback. Your e-certificate will be sent to you within a week. Thank you, one and all.